Hey guys, welcome to Cop Factor. I've decided to switch things up a bit, and before the next action video, I want to do some PvP. Dark Souls 3, just you and me. Let's see how I do. Come on, I haven't played in a while. I might be rusty. Oh, that's a big reach! Okay, so I know what weapon he's using. Oh, no. Where did all my life go? Jesus. Wow! Yep. That's where I belong. Down in the dirt. Yeah, well, that was just a warm-up round. That was just for practice. I wasn't ready. I was thinking about something else. I'm still Ashen-driven. I still got the footing from that game. I mean, come on. No. I'm only joking. No excuses in this game. I've been playing it on and off for years now. So, this is my main guy. The strength build that you see in the intro to my videos. He's pretty good. He's actually PvE oriented. I finished the entire game with him. As you can see, this is the build, but these are the rings I'm using in order to get those stats. So I'm using Prisoner's Chain to get Endurance and the Vigor to 40 to use those ultra weapons. Of course, Ringer Favor plus 3. The Knight's Ring, because I didn't invest that much into strength. As you can see, I can go up to 66 in order to get the maximum damage from the strength weapons, but I've only put 58 points, and with the ring I get 63, and of course Havel's plus 3, so I can wear all this armor and use all these weapons here, plus a shield to parry in case I ever learn how to parry. And this is basically the guy, but I know I can go even tougher. I can switch to the Exile's armor set, and this is going to give me a little extra poise from 37-ish to, let's see, to 43.17. This is much better. Well, of course, I have to swap some things around. I cannot use the dagger in my as my secondary weapon anymore, and I cannot no longer use the shield. I have to change to the cestus if I want to parry, and the cestus is all fine and good. The parry timing is good. I'm not good at parrying. I haven't PvP'd a lot. I don't do invasions, and the only times I've been invaded, I managed to repel the enemies and win, but it took its toll on me. So okay, that was like a warm-up. Let's try it again. Now these are the weapons I have infused with strength. I have a heavy dagger in case that I ever manage to get a parry. I switch over to this and I do a critical hit. The heavy broadsword, this is what I use for most of my PvE playthrough of the game. The Firelink greatsword, I only upgraded this one because my starting class was the Exiled, so having 10 stat points in every attribute helped me use weapons I never used before. I never felt the need to put points in Intelligence and Faith to get them up to at least 10 in order to use most of the weapons. So that's why I have the Firelink greatsword and also the Old King's Great Hammer, because you see they have that 10 points requirements in Faith and also in Intelligence. So yeah, the dagger, the broadsword, the Firelink greatsword, the heavy Zweihander, heavy Lothric greatsword, of course the Fume, Lorien's greatsword. I have the Ring Knight pair greatswords, but I'm missing one of the Titanite slabs, and I cannot upgrade to maximum, and I don't like how they look. I know they're one of the meta weapons, they're really good, but I don't like how they look, and I don't know, I just don't like them. I don't like fighting against them, and I also don't like using them. the heavy Exile Greatsword, and this is why I have so few points putting strength, because I had to invest up to 16 points in dexterity in order to wield this efficiently. I have the Butcher's Knife, I have the Heavy Great Axe, really good weapon, played through most of the, this was my second main weapon from the campaign. The Heavy Spike Mace, and the Leros Great Hammer. I also upgraded this to +4, but doesn't merit the investment. It's not that good, I don't really like it. Damage is significantly lower than the other weapons. So the Old King's Great Hammer, and of course the Heavy Split Leaf Greatsword. So this is all I have, all I'm using. And of course different armor sets, so I can mishmash them and get the most poise, the most the best defense and weight ratio. Okay, so this sword has served me well. Let's try the Heavy Exile Greatsword for this one. Maybe I'll fare just a little bit better. You
So that's it. I've decided to end the video on a high. I'm gonna try the other strength weapons I have maxed out in another video. Let me know what you thought. Drop a like if you enjoyed it. And I'll see you in the next one.